I was born in Vietnam.
I grew up in a town called Ancona.
In León, Guanajuato.
In Tehran, capital of Iran.
In Italy growing up, I was a bit different, and I always felt different, even if I grew up there. Maybe I liked math more than other people, and for that, people are making fun of me or thinking that somehow there was something wrong with me. And I never felt that here. When I started really discovering what was going on at Caltech was when I began working with a condensed matter theorist, Professor Nesterenko, and he was the one that introduced me to the work that Melanie Hunt was doing on the booming sand dunes. And it was very fascinating for me. So having an opportunity to come here and meeting her in person and meeting other colleagues was very exciting. And in a way, being able to work here as a professor was eventually a dream come true. People here are really smart, very driven, and at the same time, incredibly creative. Working with the students at Caltech is a fantastic experience.
I think the main influence for science was my mother. So at some point I was about to drop out of school, and I thought like my dream of becoming a scientist was vanishing. But I was lucky enough to meet the Mexican scientist that just returned from the US and say like, hey guys, I want to do some outreach and I want to teach you science every Saturday. What do you guys want to learn next? And I was like, biophysics. I knew nothing of what biophysics actually meant, but the word really sounded sexy. I was like, oh, that sounds good. I opened the book and it was like, this is what I've been looking for. This is what I wanted to be, what I wanted to learn, what I wanted to dedicate my life to. So I took my book and I Googled the name of the author. I sent him an email. Dear Mr. Phillips, PhD. You know, if I send an email to Ringo Starr, you don't expect Ringo Starr to answer back like, hey, Manuel, how's it going? He actually replied to my email. He gave me his Skype account and it was really mind-blowing. I remember the first time I talked to him. We finished the conversation and I ran to my mom and I was like, Mom, I just talked with a scientist in the US. It's incredible. But then at the end of the email, he just writes, Manuel, this is a fantastic idea. I want you to come not only for the summer, but I'm gonna sponsor you to come for the full year. And I just couldn't believe it. It was like amazing. I can't really describe with words how blessed I feel and how Rob is not only my advisor and my mentor, but a true superhero for me.
In 1975, the communists took over the south of Vietnam. My dad fled by boat when I was an infant. We never heard anything about him. So since that time on, we just have to assume that he has died. Me and my mom, we came to the United States in 1990. She worked at a sewing factory, 20 cents per t-shirt. So how many t-shirts you have to do, you know, per day, you know, to support a kid, and nobody was around me to help me, you know, so it was hard. I thought math was very easy, besides the word problems. Because even in high school, I got an A in the science, I got an A in physics, and I was like, oh, I could do science. I never thought that one day I would work at Caltech. The people are friendly, and if they feel like you want to go on to study more, they're very supportive, so you feel like family.
I grew up with the family that encouraged me to be bold and discover things by myself. I spent most of my time basically in the backyard, playing with the channels that, you know, took the water from the pond to different part of the garden, always causing problems, flooding the backyard. So water was basically the game. I challenged my imagination. I finished my mechanical engineering, got my bachelor's degree in Tehran. By then, I was married with my wife. First school that gave admission to both of us was Syracuse University. I remember when at Syracuse, we traveled to Canada. And every time we entered, they say, oh, welcome back home. You know, it was interesting because they knew that I wasn't at that time a US citizen, but they said, well, welcome back home. I became a graduate student in Caltech. And just coming here and suddenly finding this serene environment. So we came here a year before the revolution. And suddenly faculty, I didn't know. Say, hey, you guys, what are you guys doing this Friday? Come to our house. because they knew exactly what was going on. You know, they knew that they couldn't go back to see our family. They couldn't come here. So for at least, you know, 4 or 5 years, all the family connection were severed.
It doesn't matter where you're from. It doesn't matter the color of your skin. Good ideas can come from the Bay Area, and they can come as well from León, Guanajuato, or
from, you know, Kansas, or coming from India. Caltech has been always a place that anybody's willing to come to take the challenge is welcome to you.
I can do this. I'm up to the challenge. My background should not determine how far I can get.
The more point of views, the richer would be the final answer. We had different backgrounds, you know, different trainings, and that diversity was the strength. It allowed us to really tackle interdisciplinary problems with creativity, fearlessness, and ultimately success in our work.
It really changed this whole course of my life. So I decided to not to think about the old country, and that I'm a citizen of US.
I felt welcomed here. I felt that even if I was different from others, I was accepted, and receiving the citizenship was kind of a coronation of a dream.
For all of us who try to get away from our country, it's for a reason. So coming to United States is like a dream, you know, like becoming a United States citizen is also a dream.
If I could dream big, I would love to stay in the US and become a professor. My mom recently asked me when I was going back home, and I told her I wasn't sure if I should leave the country at the moment. Who knows, if I go out, visit my family, then I cannot come back in. I miss home, but I also feel like here is my second home. Like, it's really fantastic.
Now that I came here, I don't want my kids to grow up the same way that I grew up. I want them to be happy, healthy. I want them to know that they're loved. You know, now that we're living in America, you let your kids explore, and they can be whoever they want to be, and as long as they strive their best, you know, they will be successful.